Hello, hi everybody. It's another day. It's Sunday today. As always, I'm running late, but I'm not that late, so it's okay. We can have a quick chat. I am meeting my partner for lunch today, and I wanted to show you what I'm wearing. I'm keeping it pretty chilled today. I'm really not in the mood to do anything or be anywhere or whatever, but you know, Sundays are for, you know. So I wanted to show you actually what I'm wearing today, and I'm leaving my camera behind, obviously. I will be filming from my phone, and we are going to call Izikaya, which is in Hyde Park, and we're gonna have a nice lunch because we haven't seen each other all weekend, and hang out together for the rest of the afternoon. I'm a little bit frazzled. I need to head out, but this is the outfit of the day. So I've got like a very light linen shirt on, which has got a little bit of a back, and I've got some wedges on, keeping it just chilled, you know. I almost fell. Today. And yeah, I just kind of really like the look. This shirt I've had for about, for years, okay? I've had it for years. The jean is a tad big on me for a skinny jean, but it's fine. I'm okay with it. And then the shoes are from Fushimi. I got them recently, maybe a month ago, and I love them. So let me go. Let me head out. Talk to you guys a bit later. If you see something floating around in my mouth, I'm having one of my favorite sweets of life. Cadbury chocolate eclairs, they're so good. So good. I have one after 3 weeks or something, but I really like it as a sugar injection. Anyway, welcome to the new video. Hey, guys, I'm a bit tired. I just got back from work. I do want to film a little bit of content. This is going to be the vlog for this week. I do want to film a little bit of content. I finally, drum roll please, I finally got my shelves in. My shelves, yes. My shelves, they're over there. I'll show you. I need to set them up. I don't know how I'm going to do this by myself. This is the point in time in life where you need a Yolanda in your life. You know, you need a DIY Yolanda because, oh my gosh, I don't know where I'm going to even start. But it's fine. Before we go there, we're going to go upstairs. Going to shoot a little bit. A couple of things that I want to show you. And then it's mostly books, to be honest. And then there's no power at the moment. I have to actually shoot some reels, content for reels, and then then we'll take it from there. Okay. This vlog is gonna be a lot more chilled than my previous vlog, and the reason why is because I'm kind of going through a downward slump right now with the mental health and all of that. I was certain that after the previous vlog, the day after that YouTube Shorts event, I was supposed to go to a pick and pay event, the pick and pay wine and tasting festival, wine and food festival. And I was looking forward to it. But then I remember coming back from the YouTube event and I was feeling so tired, so drained, so just, I feel like I'm not straight here. Yeah, so I was feeling so tired, so drained, so just not it. And I could realize that I'm slipping. I could feel that something is not right when I got back home that Friday evening. And something wasn't right. Because when I woke up the following morning, that was it. I completely tanked. I completely lost myself. I was just crying and upset all morning, and I realized to myself that I don't want to see people in this state. I don't want to have to pretend that I'm okay and laugh and smile. And it wasn't a force for me to be there, but I do remember saying that I would be there. So there was a huge part of me that was also feeling quite guilty for not going. Quite guilty for not going. And there was just a bigger part of me that was just like, your mental health is important. You need to focus on you right now. And if you can't do it, then don't. You don't have to. So I spent pretty much the day just gone from social media, gone from the world. I was in my home all day by myself on Saturday, just crying, upset. Today's Tuesday, mind you, the following Tuesday. Just crying, just upset, just really not in a good place. Sunday was also fairly, my neighbor's dogs, of course. Every time I'm in here, my neighbor's dogs are gonna go wild. Sunday, of course, was the same. Just felt a little bit better on Sunday. Monday was yesterday. I completely tanked yesterday. I'm getting an email. Check these things, make sure it's not work. Monday I tanked even more. During the day I was fine, and then in the evening that was it. So I'm just really taking it easy on myself this week. I don't know what you can look forward to. There is one exciting thing that's downstairs that I'm gonna show you. That might be something to look forward to. That's something exciting. I definitely know for me it is. But I thought I would show you some of the things that I literally, it's my dump room, right? This is where I not only work, I'm not reckless. I don't dump things. My plant is dying. I've done everything in my power to save that baby, but I'm not winning anyway. So this room is where I work, where I do Teams meetings, all that kind of stuff. So this, as I was saying, is like a legit dump room where I put things and then I'm like, I'll come back. I'll have a look at them. I'll come back later. And then weeks go by and they're still here. They're still in here. So there's not much to show you except books, because I always get books and I get book mail. And I want to show you this stuff before I start doing reels and shorts and YouTube shorts for all of this, before I start creating content. And I also wanted to, I get asked clearly when I've been going out about my jeans. These are the jeans that I was wearing at the YouTube shorts function, and these are wide leg. So as you can see, they wide leg all the way to the bottom, and they've got a really nice pattern design. I actually like them for those days where you just want to look cool. And on that day, I wanted to look cool. I don't even know what's written on here. I really don't know. So who are you? I like you. Who are you? Okay. So I got this from a shop called Shanson's in China Mole, and I had to get them cinched in because I am quite short and the jeans were extremely long, so I had to get them cinched in. I will show you pictures of me wearing these jeans. The only one that I haven't worn, I was also asked about the ripped jeans as well. Got them from the very same shop. And also got this one from the very same shop. As I was saying, they were at the dry cleaners for alterations, at the tailors for alterations. This one, same thing, got a bit of print down here, which I think is just adorable. It's a smiley face, and what's written on here, can you see what's written on here? Do you know, I just realized now what's written on here. Okay, so we'll see. I don't know if I'll wear this jean, but it be easy. It's got a lot written on it. Typically not the type of wash of jean that I would like. I typically like very dark washes, but it's fine. It's not the end of the world. They don't fit the way that I like jeans to fit. This one, of course, because I have a smaller waist, it leaves a lot of space in the back, and I have to wear a belt with it, but I'm not sure I'm gonna wear it after what I've just seen. So we'll see, we'll see, we'll see. Also picked up a new tripod. The only reason why I picked this up is because I got this maybe 2 weeks ago. It's because I do want to create a lot more content in terms of reels and shorts and all of that. So yeah, so I picked up an extra one. I tend to leave the Manfrotto one, the Manfrotto one, which is the one that you are perched on right now. I tend to leave that one for my sit down videos, and this is the one I'll carry around for things like reels, creating reels or shorts or whatever in other parts of the house. So I picked up an extra tripod. There's a guy that sells these things in my sister's area, and that's that's pretty much what it looks like. I like this one because this part where your phone goes is quite steady. It's not that elasticy one. So this one you have to unwind it, and it goes all the way, and then you put your phone in and you wind it back down. And the tripod is also quite sturdy as well, so love that for us. Here we go. So this is also quite steady as well, and then you can also move it up. Like, there is a skincare video that I want to do, reel that I want to do, oops, slash shorts ideas. The rest is books. So last week I got book mail from Jonathan B. And Jonathan B. loves your girl. They really do. And the thing that's downstairs, the big thing that's downstairs, is because of this. Because this, these things in my house are getting out of hand. So, the first one that I got was this. And I requested this and I got it. This is Detransition Baby by Tori Peters. Reese Nearly Had It All, A Loving Relationship with Amy, An Apartment in New York, A Job She Didn't Hate. She scraped together a life of a life previous generations of trans women could only dream of. The one thing missing was a child. Then everything fell apart, and 3 years on, Reese is still in self-destruct mode, avoiding her loneliness by sleeping with married men. Hectic, deep, but very, very excited to read this, because I've heard great things about this book from people that I follow online and people that I just keep track of their content. So I'm really looking for people who actually have the similar tastes as I do when it comes to reading. Then I got, after that, I got Sundial by Katrina Ward, and this one I wanted. This one I really, really did want. Rob fears for her daughters. For Callie, who collects tiny bones and whispers to imaginary friends. For Annie, because she fears what Callie might do to her. Rob sees a darkness in Callie, one that reminds her of the family that she left behind. She decides to take Callie back to her childhood home, to Sundial, deep in the Mojave Desert. And there she will have to make a terrible choice. You can't escape the desert, you can't escape Sundial. It's obviously a thriller. A story where nothing is as it seems, a thrilling hall of mirrors full of deeply disturbing twists. And that was said by Alex Michaelides, and he's the one who wrote The Silent Patient and The Maidens. So I think I might actually read this next. And one I don't know anything about, but it's new because I saw it in the bookshop the other day. It is new, isn't it? It is new because I saw it in the bookshop the other day. Yep, 2022. This is The Gifts by Liz Hyder. It will take something extraordinary to show four women who they truly are. And it is a historical fiction because it is set in 1840. And it's a hardback, which is lovely. Lovely. Don't get hardbacks much, but this is beautiful. The cover is stunning. And then I went to the shops because I do still believe in buying books for the people who live there and who work in bookshops, but also supporting the author without just always expecting gifts, books to be given to you. So I bought two books. One of them is downstairs. Actually, it's in my car. It's called The Pallbearers Club by Paul Tremblay. I'll put a picture here. And this was me being convinced by Charity to buy, and quite a few other YouTubers that I watch online. And this is a fantasy. It is called The Starless Sea by Aaron Morgenstern. When Zachary Rowland stumbles across a mysterious library book containing details from his own life among its pages, it leads him on a quest unlike any other. So that sounds exciting. And it's lovely, floppy. Lovely, lovely. We love that. That's pretty much it. I have a meeting. The power should come back in the next 2 to 5 minutes. I have a meeting, a Teams meeting that I need to take at quarter past two. Hopefully the power will be back. I'm going to set up my laptop here actually so that I can prepare for that. And then, for the most part, that is it. I'll show you everything else. There is another PR drop that I got that is downstairs that I got last week as well. And I'm looking for that Teams link. Hi guys, how are you?
Good, thanks, and you?
Good, good, thank you. So hi, I'm done with the meeting. That was great. Took about half an hour. Cool. It's work. I'm really excited. Gonna be working with a new client for my content, and I'm really, really looking forward to that. But before, right now, I'm filming content for reels and shorts. It's a lot. It's a lot setting up cameras, doing this, but I wanna do that quickly, and then I just need about an hour or so, and then I can relax and unwind for the rest of the day, cook something nice, I guess. I took out a little bit of pork, so hey, might cook that. But what I wanted to show you was this. Hi, can you see me? Hey. I got a package last week by Sarah Creek's Wines. Yeah, I did. Here you go. Hey. So excited. The box has already been opened because my father. Okay? My father is a wine lover, and he saw this box and he was like, but why am I not getting some? So I gave him two bottles. And I'm about to film some content now for this lovely package that came my way, which I'm really looking forward to trying out the wines. Inside here, there's three bottles. And in the fridge, you always gotta keep one chilled. You always gotta keep one chilled. And I kept the, close that, I kept the Sauvignon Blanc chilled. It's nice, cold. And this is what I'm gonna be shooting the content with today. Let's put it back because I'm still gonna be talking. So Sarah Creek's Wines is a proudly South African brand. And it's got all types of wines. It's got Merlots, it's got Sauvignon Blanc, it's got Chenin, it's got, here we go, Pinotage, it's got Merlot. Did I say that already? So this is a Pinotage. Pretty. And the packaging is simple, is nice, it gets the job done. Okay? But we all know that the proof is in the pudding. You know what it is. So then we have a semi-sweet red. So for those of you who do not like Merlots or Pinotages or that kind of thing because you feel like they're a bit too bitter, maybe try the semi-sweet red. I'm about three reels in at this point, and I wanted to show you the new girlies. Yeah, I'm so excited that I probably want to do it today, but at the same time I don't. So these are the shelves that I got. I got these from Builder's Warehouse, and these are the Luska 4-tier bookshelves, and I got two of them, and they seem simple enough to get together. I think they're slightly taller than me, actually. I think so. Oh, but it's going to be elevated a little bit more. So yeah, can't wait to do all of that. That looks like it's going to be a lot of work, and I don't know if I have it in me today. I can hear them thinking out loud. Simple people acting so proud. Proud. I hear them talking about us. Yeah. I can hear them thinking out loud. One might think it's obvious. Please don't spill your mind when you don't have a clue. Hey. Tell you something for free. I am the girl I think I am. We did it! Call me Katleho DIY. I'm so tired. Oh my god, I need some water. Yeah, that's it, my darling. I just finished this. The reason why I didn't show you the starting process and all of that is because I'm doing a reel as well at the same time, so a lot of the focus was on my phone today. Oh, we're done. And the other one, I did it yesterday. My back is sweating. Okay. I woke up this morning. Hi, everybody. Did I say hi? Stay tuned. I woke up this morning. Everything hurt. Everything. So now we're going to move it to the other side of the room that I put the first one in. And I'm going to show you how that one's going to go down. Let's go. Guess who's finished? Yeah, can you see it at the back? There it is. Can you see it at the back? There it is. So nice. So nice. I feel so... Maybe let me take a seat. I feel so accomplished. It's been a... The only reason why I pulled these shelves apart and... I'm trying to catch my breath. I've been really busy. The only reason why I pull these shelves apart and put them together is because Sunday, the weekend was really rough on me, and I think I spoke about that. And my mood hasn't really improved much since until today. And the reason why until today, it's because of this. I feel like I've achieved something. I feel like I've been productive, even when I didn't want to be. I used my down space, my dark time from the weekend to try and distract myself by being busy and being productive and pulling together this bookshelf. That I did it, and I have never felt so accomplished. I've never felt so... I feel like reading is one of the things that has helped put me out of a really, really dark place. And so this feat here, and knowing that I am the one who put together these shelves, that bolt needs to be tightened. And knowing that I'm the one who put together these shelves makes me so happy. Because I did it for something that I love so much. And just looking at the books and knowing that a lot of them on this shelf I haven't read. I think all of them on this shelf I haven't read. On the other shelf, I'll show you everything now. But just looking at them... And looking at all my books, the ones that I've read, the ones I'm yet to read. The ones that I've read, I think about how the memories of where I was in my life when I was reading that book, or what was going on, or where in particular venue, place, time I was when I was reading that book. Some of the books I was on holiday, some of the books I was at my partner's place, some of the books I was at a friend's place, whatever it may be. And some of the books I've gifted to my friends as well. I own them as well. And then I give them out to my friends. And I don't know. In some really weird way, they remind me of how far I've come and what I've had to endure, because this is the year that I've read most. The most. I read a total of 35 books this year, and 35 was my goal. And I'm going to continue reading. I'm actually in the process of trying to decide what I should read. Should I stay with the Paul Bearers Club, or should I read something else? And I've never been more proud. I think feel like my camera's shaking a little bit. My hands have been busy for the last hour or so. So I am a little bit shaky, and I need some water in my system as well. But I wanted to show you this. I feel good. I feel good that I did it. Let me show you what's on my shelf. Who knows? I might just do a what's on my bookshelf video. Because a lot of YouTubers or booktubers do that. But these are my shelves. So on this end, we've got romance novels that I haven't read. So everything here I haven't read. And on this end, we have anthologies. So it's, you know, multiple stories in a book. Down here, we've got literary fiction a lot. You've got Sorrow and Bliss, All My Rage, so on and so forth. Then we've got one of my favorite authors, Sylvia Moreno Garcia, here with Velvet is the Night. And the beautiful ones, I'm kind of into Greek mythology. I always have been, but now I seem to be picking up the books that relate to it as well, like Neon Gods and Silence of the Girls. And down here, we've got the thriller section and the fantasy section. So I now have a fantasy section. I haven't read these at all. I think I'm really leaning on this one being my next read. Oops. This one being my next read, but we'll see. And then down there, it's still a mishmash, hosh-posh of books. But I really love this one. And this one is the one that's going to appear in my videos because I typically sit here. So this is pretty much what you will see when you are watching my videos. Well, half the shelf. And then here, we've got this one, which is my non-fiction shelf. So everything here is nonfiction, and as you can see, I don't read much nonfiction. We've got poetry anthologies, which are here. And here we've got some anthologies. Issa Rae's is there. White Fragility, it's not an anthology, but it's a nonfiction. Sex Lives of African Women is an anthology. So we've got also biographies. Viola Davis, When Secrets Become Stories, Atomic Habits. They're all nonfiction, basically. Still quite confused about this here shelf, but it's fine. We have given that one over there a little bit of a break. There's still quite a few books on there, but it's fine. A lot of the ones that are on there I've read before. So quite happy, quite happy. I need to bring that one back here and move this. But either way, we're fine. We're good. We're good. I'm so happy.
sick. Who am I? Who am I?